So this is my very late autumn wrap up. The reason it's so late is because I kept hoping I could finish one more book in December and then talk about it in this video and lie and be like, oh, I read all of these in autumn. But it just hasn't happened and I've come to accept that fact now. So I only have two books to talk about today and neither was very good. So the first one I'm going to talk about is Queen of Shadows by Sarah J Maas. This is the fourth book in the Throne of Glass series and it's also like the last one I have already read, so I needed to reread this before I can finish off the series and read those books for the first time. It did not hold up to my first read of it 5 years ago. For context, I gave it 5 stars back in 2015 and this is not a 5-star book. This is a 2-star book. It like barely scrapes the minimum level of enjoyment that a book should give. So firstly, the things I liked were, it's a short list. The first one is Manon, the character. I've said it before and I'll say it again, she's like the only consistently not terrible character in the series. She's kind of like how Selena was trying to be presented as in the first couple of books. She's like cruel and bloodthirsty and doesn't care about anyone. Or does she? I'm here to find out because I actually like her as a character. Another good thing about this book is that there were genuinely a couple of moments where when I was reading them, I was like, this is written in a way where it would make such a good scene in like a film adaptation. I'm going to talk specifics, so spoiler alert. I mean the scene nearish the end when like Manon and Aelin are fighting. I can't remember exactly why. The whole book's kind of forgettable. I think the witch is kidnapped Cole or something and so they go to rescue him and there's this big battle scene in like the mountains and there's like a ravine and ancient bridges crossing the ravine and there's an ancient stone temple in the middle and then it looks like Manon is going down and the whole thing's crumbling and it's very like dramatic and exciting and then Aelin saves her at the last second and there's like a moment of mutual respect between them. I really liked that. But that is like the only other thing I liked. That's the end of my positives. Now on to all the things I didn't like. There aren't too many to mention in this video, so I'm just going to focus on a couple of the big ones. After giving it some thought, I think that my biggest issue is this book has the vibe that Sarah J Maas sat down and she did like one attempt at outlining the book and the plot for the whole series, like what was going to happen, and then she just sort of winged it and like never came back to fill in some of the details and fill in some of the holes in the plotting and the information available. And so the whole thing just feels quite like muddled and underdeveloped. There are so many moments that just don't feel thought out or that like don't have any kind of logic within them. And there were just lots of moments where I kept thinking, what is this? What about that? Why are we assuming A is B when we have very little information about this whole thing? Why can't the characters just find out this missing information? And the characters, bless them, they're trying their very best to look busy, but not very much is happening. Everything just feels a little bit too muddled, and like the more I tried to think about it and understand and reason why that would be the case, the less sense it made to me. I also have quite a lot of issues still with the characters themselves and their characterization within the book. Sarah J Maas keeps telling us about them, but there's very little like action or evidence to back this up. A lot of them feel very similar, but at the same time I can never tell how they're actually going to react within a scene or what they're going to do. They just seem to be whatever the plot needs them to be. And also a lot of the characters who weren't completely terrible in previous books kind of sucked in this one, except for Manon. She's still cool. And also the new character of Elide, not terrible, but I would put good money on her character also becoming like muddled and like a bit ruined in later books in the series. So those were like the main gripes I have with this book. I'm giving it 2 stars overall. I just have like one specific thing I wanted to mention. It's towards the end of the book, so spoiler alert, but right at the end when they're all kind of like mostly together and they're going north to Terracin and it's gonna be like the first time Aelin's been there in 10 years or whatever, it's a very emotionally charged journey, and then on like the second to last page Rowan or someone is like, oh Aelin, come look at this, it's just up ahead, and she's like, what is? Like, where did you think you were going, Aelin? Obviously he's talking about Terracin! And that's just another example of like how consistently stupid Aelin is. Finally, this book is very much a filler book, I think. I've just started reading the fifth one, and looking back on this, it's kind of a filler book. And also, easily 150 to 200 pages could have just been edited out. So it was disappointing, but it was a disappointment I saw coming. And so the only other book I finished in autumn was The Turn of the Key by Ruth Ware. I thought I was reading this on the recommendation of Kayla from Books and Lala, but I was not. So I don't know who it was I saw talking about this on BookTube and that like made it sound really good and I wanted to read it, but I shouldn't have listened because it was also disappointing. The premise is cool. It's a thriller book about a woman called Rowan who gets hired as a nanny in like a house in the middle of nowhere in Scotland, I think, and then like creepy and unexplained things start happening. And those like creepy, spooky things were like my favourite thing about the book. I loved those descriptions. I loved like the uneasy atmosphere everything had. Never knew who to trust. I was loving all of that. It was mainly the ending which let me down. I can appreciate it, and I understand what the author was doing, but doesn't mean I have to like it. It felt very anticlimactic for me. And while the whole book did feel actually quite realistic, which not many thrillers do, I was holding out hope for like a big dramatic ground-shaking ending and like some really big twist to happen, and I just don't think it did. Also, this is an epistolary novel, meaning it is told through like letters one character is writing, and I should have known going in I wouldn't like that because I don't like epistolary books. I just think it's like the worst thing in the world. Like, no one is ever going to sit down and write a book's worth of correspondence to another character in like 3 days. It's just not gonna happen. So that like really irritated me at the beginning, but luckily I liked the spooky creepy bits more than I disliked the format. So I did get over it in the end, but consider this a warning if you're considering this book and you don't like epistolary novels, it's probably not the one for you. So even though I'm only giving it 2 stars, I would read something else by Ruth Ware. I liked the beginning bit of the story and I liked the writing, and her most recent book, I think One by One, is currently like doing the rounds on BookTube and most people seem to like it, so I would consider reading that next year. It was just this one was not great. And finally, I want to give a dishonourable mention to the only book I have DNF'd this year, which was The Woman in White by Wilkie Collins. It was so boring. I got the audiobook, downloaded it. It was like 28 hours long, but I thought, it's fine, I can get through this. I'll listen to it on my commute to work. I listened to about 90 minutes over about a week because it was so incredibly dull. I couldn't listen to more than like 15, 20 minutes at one time. And I just thought, life is too short to waste on a book this boring. I care so little that I'm not even tempted to go and look up the ending online and see what actually happened, because I mostly do that with books I don't finish. I kind of want the satisfaction of knowing what happened in the end. With this one, I don't even care to do that. And I even came across like an accidental spoiler when I was scrolling through Wikipedia months later, and even that wasn't enough to like make me curious and want to go and find out what happened. I just don't care. And I did see this coming because it's like 1,000 pages long, literally 1,000 pages, I think, and I knew I wasn't gonna like it. So it just confirms my general dislike of older classic novels. And I'm not sorry, I'm only sorry I wasted those 90 minutes of my life trying to get through the audiobook. So that was my very disappointing autumn wrap-up in terms of both quantity and quality. I'm currently reading the 5th book in the Throne of Glass series, Empire of Storms, and I'm also hoping to like sneak in like a really short book from my TBR before the end of the year, because it would bring up my total number of books read this year to 40, which would be great. So I'm hoping that will happen, and I'm hoping they'll be more enjoyable than these two, though that wouldn't be hard.